with 20,000 or else, while the other is yet a great way off, he sendeth an ambassage and desireth conditions of peace. The Lord is saying very clearly, we need to plan our lives. But what then does it mean? Take no thought. You know, that's the way the Hebrew people, the Jewish people, that's where they talked about worry and anxiety. That's how they talked about something that, you know, will so much disturb them. They become so concerned, they are not able to concentrate. That's worry. That's a different thing. And look at it in the Bible yourself. And look at 1 Samuel chapter 9. 1 Samuel chapter 9. We're looking at what it means when it says, take no thought. 1 Samuel chapter 9. We're looking at verse 5. 1 Samuel chapter 9, verse 5. And when they were come to the land of Zuph, Saul said to his servant that was with him, come and let us return, lest my father leave caring for the asses and take thought for us. Take thought. Lest my father will not even bother anymore, will not be concerned anymore about the asses that are lost. And because now he can't find us and he doesn't know our whereabouts, he becomes worried. He becomes anxious and he begins to take thought. Look at chapter 10 of 1 Samuel verse 2. 1 Samuel chapter 10 verse 2. When thou art departed from me today, then thou shalt find two men from by Rachel's sepulchre in the border of Benjamin at Zelzah. And they will say unto thee, the asses which thou wentest to seek are found, and lo, thy father has left the care of the asses and sorroweth for you, saying, what shall I do for my son? You see that? Has not become worried, has become anxious. So when the word of God says, take no thought, what it means is don't be worried. Don't be anxious that you are so much sorrowful in mind. You're so much concerned. You're so much full of care. And it oppresses your mind. It does not allow you to sleep. That's what he's saying. That you will not have that kind of disposition of mind. Mark chapter 13 verse 11. Mark chapter 13. The command of the Lord forbidding us to worry. Forbidding us, saying you must not be anxious. Just take all your cares, all your concerns, and lay everything upon the Lord. Mark chapter 13, verse 11. But when they shall lead you and deliver you up, take no thought beforehand what they shall speak. Neither do ye meditate, premeditate, for whatsoever shall be given to you in that hour, that speak ye, for it is not ye that speak, but the Holy Ghost. It's saying that the Holy Ghost will be with you, and therefore any challenge you have, any difficulty you have, he'll put the word in your mouth. Don't be so anxious and so worried. What am I going to say when he questioned me? The Lord is telling us, just calm down, and then he'll give you the solution when the problem comes. I said he'll give you the solution when the problem comes. In Philippians chapter 4, Philippians chapter 4, we're reading from verse 6. Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. This is still the same commandment that the Lord is giving us through the mouth or through the pen of Paul the apostle. Be not anxious, don't be worried. In Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, be careful for nothing. Be careful for nothing. That just means in nothing be anxious, in nothing be worried. Whatever is happening, whatever, in nothing, don't allow yourself to become worried about your personal life, about your health, about your job, about the future, about getting married, about having children. In nothing, be worried. In nothing, be anxious about the state of your children. Where is that boy now? Where is that girl now? What's happening to that child? God is taking care. He knows where the child is. He knows where the daughter is. He knows where your husband is. He knows where your wife is. Don't be anxious. He's saying, in nothing, be anxious, be careful for nothing. You see, there are people that almost destroy themselves with anxiety. The wife goes to the market, there is a hold up, and the wife is not back immediately. And now the man is worried and anxious. What's happening? Has this happened? Has this happened? Or the child goes to school, and the child does not come back in normal time. The child should come back, and then we're worried almost to death. And it says, be careful for nothing. That is, in anything at all, don't allow yourself to have that kind of depression, oppression in your mind, that you're worried about everything, that you're always putting negative interpretation on whatever is happening in your life. And now it goes on in that verse 6, but in everything, everything small or great, everything personal, everything domestic, everything in the family, everything about your job, everything about your health. If you're sick, God will heal you. If you're jobless, He'll provide for you. In everything, whatever the problem may be, just live a life without care, without worry, without anxiety. It says, in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. And then in verse 7, and the God of peace, which, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest. Do you realize when people worry, when they are anxious, they are always thinking about things that are not true, things you cannot prove. Maybe this has happened, but it has not happened. Maybe that is happening, but it's not happening. Maybe they are thinking like this. Maybe they are acting like this. Whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. No more worry, no more anxiety. The Lord will take care of our lives. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7. Casting all your care upon Him. Casting how many of our cares? You know, there are people that will cast their small, small cares on the Lord. But the big, big ones about how to get a job, the big ones, how to get a wife, the big ones, how to have a husband, the big ones, how to be free from the enemy, they carry that on themselves. The small, small cares, they say, God, you can handle this. And then they are worried to death. They lose their sleep because of the big, big ones. I think you are wise. If you're going to worry at all, I think the small, small ones you should take care. And then the big ones that you know you cannot carry, all that one, you hand over to the Lord. You know, make yourself look like a Moses, for example. Here you have all these 3 million people. And then Moses said, Lord, where am I going to find water for these people? Do you know that God does not need an ocean? He does not need a sea to be able to give water to 3 million. Even if there's a dry rock, it can bring water for them. The big problems, hand that over to the Lord. That's how to be free from worry and anxiety. The ones you know you cannot solve, and the ones you know are bigger than you. It's like, you know, they were crying, how are we going to get food to eat? If Moses was to bear that burden, Moses said, what do you say? All the big, big cares, I take over, I give to the Lord. How He will give them, I'll give them food. You know, when we worry, when we say, are we going to give food to these people? You know where we're looking? We're looking at the field. We're looking at the ground so that we can get food for all these people. But when that thing was handed over to God, God did not bring the manna from the ground. He brought it from the sky. Now you cannot do that. You cannot bring the food from the sky, but He can bring it from the sky. He can bring the water from the rock. Therefore, all your cares, especially the ones that you know, this is a problem I cannot solve. This is a big one. Hand it over to God and God will take care of you. And even the small ones, we can give over to the Lord. The little headache and the little fever and the little, you know, challenges. And, you know, there is no supper, there is no breakfast. Am I going to pay school fees? All the cares, we're going to hand everything over to the Lord. And I'm telling you, before this month runs out, you have a testimony already. Casting all your care, all, you know, the devil will try to bother your mind and make you to think high about this. You say, Satan, shut up. God is taking care of that. High about this one, Satan, I said, I'm not in conversation with you. Shut up. God is taking care of that. What will you do if something happens? If it happens, God is watching. That reminds me of, you know, a little girl that just got born again, became a child of God, and received Jesus into her heart. And somebody said, you know, the devil is going about as a running lion. And what if in the night the devil comes as a running lion and knocks at the door of the place you are sleeping? What will you do? Oh, the little girl said, that's very simple. I'll say, Jesus, go and meet him at the door. Casting all your cares upon the Lord. And when any challenge comes, just say, Jesus, meet them at the door. And then you stand behind the Lord Jesus Christ and see Jesus will knock out their head once again. Casting all your cares upon him because he cares for you. It's not that he will care for you in the future. No, he cares for you now. It's not that he cared for you in the past. He's caring for you when? Now. And look at Psalm 55. And this is a verse. Maybe you have never read this. You need to mark this one in your Bible. We're looking at Psalm 55. Psalm 55, we're looking at verse 22. Cast thy burden upon the Lord, and he shall sustain thee. Are you so heavy that God cannot carry you? Are your needs so big that God cannot carry? He carried 3 million people. How about you? Just give yourself to the Lord. You are a child of God. He saved your soul. Will he neglect your body? He saved your soul. He's preparing a mansion for you in heaven. Will he allow you to live on the street here on earth? No. He's caring for you. And so he says, cast thy burden upon the Lord, and he shall sustain thee. He shall never permit, he shall never allow, he shall never suffer the righteous to be moved. You will not be moved. Nothing will shake you away from the place the Lord has put you, and the blessing of the Lord will be upon you in Jesus' name. It tells us in Luke chapter 21, verse 34, and take heed to yourselves, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and the cares of this life. And the cares and the concerns and the worry and the anxiety of this life, so that they come upon you unawares, unprepared. We have seen the commandment of the Lord. Now, I want to see the reason why Jesus gave this command. That leads us to point number two: common creatures' freedom from worry and anxiety. Common creatures' freedom from worry and anxiety. In Matthew chapter 6, reading from verse 26 and verse 27. Behold the fowls of the air. The Lord now wants to illustrate the teaching he's giving us. He has already told us, don't be anxious. He has taught us, don't be worried. Now he's going to give us the reason why we should never allow any worry, any anxiety. Behold the fowls of the air. For they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Now you need to read that verse properly. Whenever you read, make sure you understand what the Bible is saying, what the verse is saying. I'm going to read it again. Pay attention. And if I use a word which you know is not the right word, then you say no. Are you ready? Behold the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, yet their heavenly Father feedeth them. Their heavenly Father No, he is not their father, he is our father. You know what he's saying? He's saying that they are just beasts, animals, worthless creatures, insignificant scripture, like creatures. If all the birds in the sky, if they fall down and die, the world will still continue. If all the dogs, if they fall down and die, the world will still continue. And yet, those insignificant creatures, God takes care of them. Are we not more significant than they? We are the children of God. He is our Heavenly Father. And his Heavenly Father is taking care of those useless, worthless, insignificant creatures. Why do we think he's going to abandon us? It's like, you know, I get to somebody's house and this person owns poultry and he has a lot of chicks or chicken, and then he has some dogs and some pigs, and then I see that he feeds them very well. Then I will say, well, if this man can feed the fowls and the chickens like this, I have no doubt he will feed his own children very well. Or do you think a man who is reasonable will feed all those animals and then his child will starve to death? No. If God can take care of the fowls in heaven, of the animals that are worthless and insignificant, and is feeding them, how much more your Father who is in heaven, he will feed you. He will take care of you. And you know, sometimes I look at these birds, and even when we're having our service here, they fly around as if they don't worry. Are they worried? And then sometimes all of us were here, and then you see those birds, they just fly like this and fly like this, and then when they want to sing, they sing. And whether we like their song or not, even when we sing that they are disturbing us, they just carry on singing. They don't mind what you think or what I think. If those birds are like that, and they are free from care, and they are free from anxiety, and then they are not talking to one another, they are not talking to one another saying, how are we going to get breakfast tomorrow? How will this happen tomorrow? They just know. They just know. When tomorrow comes, our food will come. Now, if these birds are like that, why me? I can reach. I can pray. I can think. And I can see all the miracles the Lord has done. If all these birds are not worried, why am I worried? Why are you worried? I said, why are you worried? There's no reason for you to worry. He will take care of us. That's what Jesus was illustrating to them. Anytime you see all those birds in the sky, and you see that they live without worry, they live without anxiety, then you tell yourself, I have no reason to be worried. I have no reason to be anxious. He tells us in that chapter 6. At the end, are ye not much better than they? Which of you by taking thought can add one cubit to his stature? And let's see, for example, Genesis chapter 1. Do you know that when God created this universe, the earth, he made provision for the birds? God is very thoughtful. He does not leave anything unplanned. He planned for the birds. In Genesis chapter 1 verse 30, and to every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to every thing that creepeth upon the earth, wherein there is life, I have given every green herb for meat. And it was so. He made provision for the birds from the time of creation. Look at Job chapter 38. Job chapter 38, and we're reading from verse 41. Job 38 verse 41. Who provideth for the raven his food? He provideth for the raven his food. And when his young ones cry unto God, they wonder for lack of meat. They wonder about, and then he provides for them. If we'll provide for the ravens, how much more will he provide for you? I'm saying he will provide for you. And from tonight, don't allow any worry, any anxiety. Every time you just look around and you see God is providing for all these animals, the Lord will provide for you. And you know what I've discovered? It is the animals we keep at home. Those are the ones that starve. But if you go to the bush where all those animals in the bush, they don't have any human owner. They just go about. They don't starve. They don't starve. Only the ones that will keep at home, they are the ones that starve. The ones that starve and the ones you have to take care of this way and that way. When God is taking care, there is no failure at all. And if you will hand over yourself to the Lord completely, there's not going to be any failure. In Psalm 104, reading from verse 10. He sendeth the springs into the valleys which run along the hills. They give drink to every beast of the field, and the wild asses quench their thirst. That's how God is taking care of them. And then in verse 12, by them shall the fowls of heaven have their habitation, which sing among the branches. He watereth the hills from his chambers, and the earth is satisfied with the fruit of thy works. He causes the grass to grow for the cattle, and the herb for the service of man, for he that he may bring forth food out of the earth. Look at verse 27. In verse 27, these wait all upon thee, that thou mayest give them their meat in due season, that thou givest them, they gather, thou openest thine hand, their field with good. And yet the Lord is saying, he's taking care of all those animals, all the birds. How much more will he take care of us? Now you know what worry and anxiety does. Worry and anxiety makes us to just take all our situation into our hands. And then we do some things that hurt ourselves, that destroy us. Let me show you an example of what I mean. When you have problems and then the Lord is saying, don't worry, and then you worry. Don't be anxious, and then you're anxious. Take no thought, and then you're taking thought. And you think God may be late, or God may forget, but God will not forget you. And when you think God will forget, see the things we do, and we hurt ourselves. I want you to look at Genesis chapter 27. Genesis chapter 27. I'm reading from verse 46. You remember what the Lord said? Take no thought for your life. Take no thought. Don't be anxious. Don't be worried for your life. What shall we eat? What shall we drink? When with that shall we be clothed? Because it says your heavenly Father takes care of you.